system resolution and dynamic range. After a preliminary observation of the power delay profiles on various measurement points at different bandwidths, it is noticed that the noise threshold is constant, slightly below minus 90 decibels. Besides that, as the power in the profile decays with delay, there are no observable multipath components above the noise threshold approximately 60 ns after the time instant of transmitting the pulse for each bandwidth. According to this fact, the display window from 0 ns to 80 ns is chosen for all considered bandwidths and measurement points. Since this window is sampled at 801 points, the display resolution for all measurements is 0.1 ns. The temporal resolution of the measurement system is equal to the inverse of the bandwidth and has a value greater than the display resolution. Otherwise, the display window would exceed the maximum observable delay, Havinen et al., 2002. Once the VNA was calibrated, the pulse shape was observed at the time delay domain for each different bandwidth, figure 6. All pulses have a different peak value at tau equals 0, which is caused by normalizing the measurement results to the total energy of the pulse. The shape of the calibrated pulse for different bandwidths. The VNA provides a windowing feature which is needed because of the abrupt transitions at the start and stop frequencies of the measured frequency span. The band limiting of a frequency domain response causes overshoot and ringing in a time domain response. This limits the usefulness of the time domain measurement in terms of the sidelobes and a pulse wider than the system resolution. The window used in the presented measurements is the normal window, which has a sidelobe level 44 decibels below the pulse peak value and extends the pulse width to value of 3.84 times the system resolution for a bandpass mode, Hewlett-Packard Company, 1989. This has a direct consequence in spreading the pulse spatially, so that the spatial resolution of the system is degraded and the system can no longer resolve the multipath components with the precision expected from the system resolution. Another consequence is that when observing the delays in relation to the time instant of the peak of the transmitted pulse, one can observe a certain amount of energy received in negative delay times. To eliminate this, several power delay profiles where the total energy was not captured are removed from the final set of measured data. Hence, the minimum measurement distance is half of the spatial width of the pulse at a given bandwidth. Furthermore, the RMS delay spread is estimated for each pulse, as this value is to be subtracted from the measured RMS delay spread of each power delay profile, Section 6. The results are presented in Table 2. System and pulse parameters for different bandwidths. Figure 7 shows a detail of normalized power profiles for different bandwidths. All the profiles are measured at 0.78 meters antenna separation. It is evident that the measurement system with a narrow bandwidth cannot resolve as much multipath components as the same measurement system with wider bandwidth. A detail of normalized power delay profiles ATD equals 0.78 meters for different bandwidths.